Hello, my name is Karin Bonne. I'm a researcher at Artevelde University College in Ghent, that is Belgium. And this is my colleague, Caroline. And I think I have 6 minutes left to introduce you in the world of storytelling. And it all happened some 2 years ago. I wanted to do some research about how using your talents in setting up a business. And I found lots of tools and instruments in how to use your talents in an organization or in an enterprise. But there was nothing about how to use it for startups. So I bumped into a colleague, you, and she said, let's use storytelling for that purpose. And that's how we started our storytelling journey in 2013. Storytelling is all about telling stories, and everybody tells stories to his children or on Monday morning to his colleagues. And in a professional way, storytelling is often used in marketing, in journalism, in corporate communication, but not for startups. So what we do is we focus on the link between the entrepreneur and his business idea. And what we see is when the entrepreneur has a really good match with his business idea and becomes one with his idea, then telling a story goes without saying. So we focus on the match and on the story. What motivates us is passion business. So we think that when an entrepreneur is passionate about his business, he will be motivated and become hopefully a successful entrepreneur. So what we do with the storytelling method, we try to search for the passion, to unleash the passion from the unconscious to the conscious and match it to the business idea. These are the theories we use to develop the storytelling method. For telling stories, we use the System 1 from Kahneman, that's the fast emotional part of our brain. And we need story elements to have a good story, and then the story should stick. And to have a story that sticks, it should be credible, it should be emotional. So to have an emotional story, we should start with why. To start with why from Simon Sinek is really key in our method. And then we have a circle that is complete. As I said, telling stories is the emotional part of doing business, and normally we focus on the data and the figures, and we should write a business plan or fill in the business model canvas. But once the canvas is filled in and all the boxes are ticked, we need a story to tell the canvas to a financial guy or to a client. So we developed a storytelling workshop, a full-day workshop, with a maximum 10 participants. And it's really important that the participants have a really concrete idea, a willingness to start up a business. And the other value of the workshop is the feedback they get from the trainer, the feedback they get from the other participants. We did several test workshops in several settings with student startups, with ethnic startups, with unemployed people who want to start up a business, with starters who started some years ago. And we evolved from half a day to a full day, and we could go to 2 days or 3 days. We start today the workshop with a pitch, and normally, almost all participants only tell us what they will do, perhaps how. They never tell us why they do those things. So throughout the day, we evolve to the why and the story. And how do we do that? Well, in the morning before lunch, we catch and we form stories. So we have several exercises, and we focus on the match of the entrepreneur with his idea. Then after lunch, we visualize and we tell stories, and we use a mood board to do that. So on the next slide, you will see some snapshots of the dating, so the pitch, and then the mood board. But I would like to tell the story of Mohammed and Sara. They have a Pakistani origin, and Sara was born in Belgium, but her husband, Mohammed, wasn't. And he came to Belgium to marry Sara, and he couldn't find a job. And Mohammed is a cook, and so is Sara's father. He's a cook. And they had the idea to open a snack and, in Ghent. Ghent is a university city with lots of students. They wanted to open a snack with healthy Pakistan food. Throughout the workshop and the exercises we did, it became very clear that by opening the snack, they also wanted to give a positive image of Pakistan through these Pakistanese healthy food things. And it was very important for them to pass on these ancient recipes from their parents and grandparents. So we had a great idea of integrating stories in their menu cards instead of just putting this is rice with chicken and so on. What is next? So this research project run 1 year. We have the as a result a workshop, and we have a training trainer. And then now the workshop is proposed to our own students in Artevelde University College for different disciplines. As I said before, it's very important. It's more like an exclusive workshop because it's very important that the student has a concrete idea. As you all know, starting up a business is work in progress. So having your story is work in progress. At the end of the day, you don't have a finished story. Yeah, it's just the beginning. We also integrated the workshop in a European Social Fund project. It's called Ethnic Entrepreneurs Innovate, where we make a toolbox to stimulate ethnic entrepreneurs to innovate in their business concepts. Most of our ethnic entrepreneurs are necessity entrepreneurs. They start up a business because they can't find a proper job. For them, it's very important to search the passion, what are you good at, what are your talents, and match it to the business ID. We also use storytelling in the toolbox in another manner. We wrote down some stories from role models. And this is the digital story of Karima, who has a small snack, a hamburger snack thing in Ghent. And we would like to finish our presentation with the best practice. I think there's someone from Holland here in the room who perhaps knows Schoedem. Schoedem is a hairdresser and a barber in Rotterdam, in Holland.
Is it loud enough?
Yeah, but it's loudest, I think. So they are a hairdresser and a barber in Holland, and there are five of them, and they're based their concept on the values of the 50s. Like men are men, we have time to do things that are nice, and there's not much choice, yeah? So limited choice, and it's a good example of how these guys use their passion in their concept. Let's just look.
We do 12 haircuts, maybe 14, so that a gentleman comes in. He knows he's gonna leave the shop with the best haircut that we can give.
What we do is not fashion, we do style.
But we come here in the morning, there'll be 20 guys waiting in front of the shop every day. It's not even all about the haircuts. It's about being a part of this thing that's happening here.
I have to travel for over an hour to get here, but I do it every month.
I travel down from Amsterdam.
I'm from Albania.
From Romania.
South part of Holland.
Yeah, it's totally authentic, I think.
It's good to see craftsmanship at work.
I think it's the free beer sometimes.
Schoedem actually translates scumbag. We get guys from the street, the real people. We get the punks, the psychos, the bikers, the rockabillys. Those were the kinds of haircuts that I just love to do the most. And now that we have the shop, I get to do that kind of haircuts all day long. These guys know they look good when they leave the shop. That's what you do it for. I mean, guys want to look good. We love the attention. We love what is happening to us. But in the end, it's all about giving a goddamn good haircut.
So with scumbags, like, but decent scumbags.
I mean, this is fashion business, and they rock it.